Originally created by Disney in 1951. But this isn't Disney. So we're in for a wonderful treat today as RHSVA tells the new story of Alice in Wonderland. We pick up as a teenage Alice returns to the magical world from her childhood adventures, where she is set to reunite with old friends and learn of her true destiny. To end the Red Queen's reign of terror on Frappish Day.
Thank you.
White Rabbit, she thinks she remembers from her childhood dreams. But could it be that she is truly the Alice that the White Rabbit seeks? Join in on some fun. Now there's nothing wrong with a dance among friends, Tweedledum, Tweedledee, or even Rabbit. But you need to know when you're dancing with friends exactly who's lurking around the band. Thank you. But you are much more Alice than you used to be. In fact, you're almost Alice. How can I help you if you don't even know who you are, stupid girl?
I'm not stupid. My name is Alice. I live in London. My mother's name is Helen, and my sister's name is Margaret. My father is Charles Kingsley. He had a vision that stretched halfway around the world, and nothing ever stopped him. I'm his daughter. I'm Alice Kingsley.
Alice, at last, fraptious day is upon us, and as the scroll has foretold, you are to kill the Jabberwocky. You must retrieve the Vorpal Sword stolen by the Red Knave and hidden in the Red Queen's court. The vorpal sword is the mortal enemy of the Jabberwocky. All you have to do, Alice, is hold on to it. Everyone should have a sinister friend with a sinister smile. That's on the case. The Cheshire Cat is on the case. He's taking his old friend Alice
to meet with other friends, and they've waited a long time for the right Alice to arrive. And what else should they have done during all that time but to continue a tea party, of course, waiting on their friends. Cheshire Cat. It is time to go to the Red Queen's court to retrieve the Vorpal Sword. gentlemen, it is now time to rejoin Alice, the Mad Hatter, and the Cheshire Cat on their search for the Vorpal Sword. It's been a long and tedious journey, but it's time for the Red Queen to go down on the quest to find the Vorpal Sword. Alice, the Cheshire Cat, and the Mad Hatter must sneak into the Red Queen's court, where they find frenemies engaged in a lovely game of croquet. But these frenemies play croquet safely, because they're afraid that the Red Queen with his orbis bulbous head will be prepared to take theirs.
last, I am able to return the sword to its rightful owner, the White Queen.
Two sisters. One with her large, orbous, bulbous head. One with her dainty purity. Prepare to bring this to an end. It is Fractious Day. This is war. Not like you've known it before. It's red. It's what? A battle. Now, ladies, when you go to battle, you better bring your best. Tricks up their sleeves. This too is for sale. When you think you need to go to battle. On the run. It's Fractious Day. The name is on their tail. The Red Court is in trouble. Now, ladies, if you have to go to battle, you might think sequins is it.
But a bear mid-drift after a trip to the gym is about to take the red court out. And it's for sale. You can look that good when you walk into a room. Cut up a little fabric, the white court is in session. Rapturous day. We know how this is going to end. Finished battle, the men can come. It's a battle of the red and white coats. Two sisters, but only one will survive.
It's time for Alice to defeat the Jabberwocky. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been RHSPA's Alice in Wonderland. Please welcome Ballet One. Actually, I'm sorry, the White Rabbit. Good girls, they used to be silent, violent, living.
Ballet 3, Hip Hop Jazz 1, Hip Hop Jazz 2, and Hip Hop Jazz 3. Modeling 1, Modeling 3, Modeling 4, Sarah Lloyd, Adriana Fullerton, Raven Townsend, Monique Nia Jones, I'm sorry, Monica, Miss Diamond, Miss Brandy, Mr. Jason, and last but not least, Miss Rhea. Now, if you've enjoyed these wonderful facilities, you should know that there are memberships available to DuSable Museum. See any one of their employees after the show. RHSPA, take your bow. And now, dance it out.
From RHSPA. Stand up. Can I get the gift? Give it up for my dads. So these men, stand up. These men bring it to class with them every week with their kids. They take it home with them every week with their kids. They're dropping off and picking up. They're doing hair. They're texting about what color the ribbon is supposed to be. Don't tell me fathers don't care. And I want to make sure you know that we appreciate you coming out here today and celebrating with us. And so we had a raffle. Mr. Henderson was responsible for pulling the name of the RHSPA dad who's going to get this. So I'm telling you who to get if he didn't pull your name. It's not me. This is going to Mr. Jay Beasley. And I will tell you, if I had enough money to do it, it's for all of my kids, you would all take a gift. But give them a round of applause. You all are amazing. Thank you. Can I get the flowers out? Okay, so I'm gonna have my graduates, eighth grade, high school, step on up here. I've got have some amazing young people who graduated this year, getting ready to go on to bigger and better things, and I want to salute them and celebrate them. Come on up. Right here. These young people are that I have the pleasure of having in my presence. So Miss Brittany here was valedictorian of her 8th grade graduating class. Yes. She's not just smart, she's a beautiful girl as well. Brilliant young woman. And where are you going to school in the fall?
Lindblom.
Okay. Are you ready? Did you ever think that this would be so much fun? I know, I'm glad you're back. Now tell us where you're going to high school this year and your name and where you graduated from.
My name is Kennedy. I graduated from St. Thomas the Apostle and I'm going to Marist High School.
All right, good luck, Miss Kennedy. Oh, Yasmin, tell us a little bit about you with that pretty smile matching mine.
My name is Yasmin Mason. I graduated from Owen Scholastic Academy, and I would like to attend Kenwood Academy.
And she's going to attend Kenwood Academy. We're going to put that in the prayer box, right? You're going to Kenwood. And you know, we can't give a young man flowers. We have a little something more special for the young man to fit him. And this young man, LaVance, I met him at his grammar school, and he was in what, sixth grade, maybe fifth grade? Sixth grade, and he said, Mom, I want to go to Miss Rhea's school. He's been with us for the past 2 years, has grown immensely. I'm so excited for his future. And let's tell us a little bit about yourself and where you're going.
My name is LaVance Sagey. I attend St. Elizabeth, and I'm going to Urban Prep Englewood.
Urban Prep! Woo! Thank you, guys. You can go back to your spaces. And I have one young man who's not here. Mr. Tumani Simons, who is a senior graduated, he's going to Illinois State University on a full scholarship for track, one of our premier male models. He could not be here today, but I would be remiss if I didn't tell you how awesome I think he is, and he's going to do great, and we're proud to say he's one of our own. So give a little hand clap for Mr. Tumani Simons. And so you know what doesn't happen? If you don't keep it fresh and young, and my alumni helped me keep it fresh and young. So I'm gonna ask Miss Adriana to step up, Miss Raven Townsville, Miss Monica Nia Jones, our Alice, and my Sarah Lloyd, my rabbit, to come on up to the front. So these young ladies give of themselves tirelessly. They are in college working full-time jobs and graduate school and making it happen for themselves. And they found time to come and help Miss Rhea with her kids and her production. And you all don't know how much I appreciate you. You have to understand that there is no me without you. And so I want to make sure that you know how much you're loved. And so I have some special flowers for you guys. You were our first, and I'm so proud to say it. Bless you. Thank you for everything. Okay, that concludes the show. Have I missed anything? All right then, we're gonna party, back it up, close the curtains. Parents, we're gonna dismiss from the stage. We're gonna ask everybody who's not a parent to exit. Parents, move up to the front. We're gonna close this curtain, and then we will bring your class out one at a time. You'll get to take your baby right from the stage. In the meantime, let's get some uptown funk and let's move this party backwards.
Don't believe it. just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch.
Before we leave, let me tell y'all a little something.